Hello students, welcome to Standard 12 Mathematics, Chapter 1 Relations and Functions. This is lecture number 32. Definition 14 now we have. Next definition. In that given a binary operation from A cross A to A with identity element T belongs to A. This is the binary operation given and its identity element T is also given. An element A belongs to A if we take any element A in given set A is said to be invertible with respect to operation binary. When this A will be invertible, when we can say this A is invertible, if there exists an element B also there, it is also belongs to A, such that A binary B equals to E and B binary A also equals to E. If this happens, this B is called inverse of A and denoted as A inverse equals to B, where E is again identity element, it is given. Understood? When A is invertible, we can say if A into B equals to E or B into A, B binary A is also equals to E, then B is called the inverse of A and denoted by A inverse. So to B. Related to this example 39 we have, so that minus A is the inverse of A for addition operation plus on R, and 1 upon A is the inverse of A not equal to 0 for the multiplication operation multiply on R. So minus A is the inverse of A in addition operation, and 1 upon A is inverse of A, which is A is not equal to 0 in multiplication operation. That we have to show. So the solution here we have done by the definition, this definition given. For being inverse, what should be? A binary B should be equal to B binary A equals to E, E for identity elements. For addition operation, you know that identity element is 0. So here A plus minus A, if we do, this will be A plus minus A minus A 0. Identity element T we are getting for addition. And it's reverse also, minus A plus A if you do, then also minus A plus A equal to 0. Identity element we are getting in addition. Therefore, minus A is the inverse of A for addition. Similarly, for multiplication we will see, for A not equal to 0, it is given already in the question. A into 1 upon A is 1, and this 1 is identity element for multiplication, so we are getting 1. And 1 upon A into A is also 1, for every A belongs to 1. So this 1 upon A is the inverse of, for the multiplication. 1 upon A is the inverse of A for multiplication. This way, minus A is inverse of A in addition, 1 upon A is inverse of A in multiplication operation. That way we have shown with the help of this definition. Now example 40. So that minus A is not the inverse of A belongs to N for addition operation plus on N, and 1 upon A is not inverse of A belongs to N for multiplication operation multiply on N for A is not equal to 1. This 39 was on R, real number. So we have seen that minus A is the inverse of A in addition and 1 upon A is the inverse of A in multiplication. But if we take the set as n, natural number set, then this will not be happen. Means minus A will not be the inverse of A, and 1 upon A will not be the inverse of A in multiplication operation on n actually. So in solution we will clear it. Since minus A does not belong to n, if A belongs to n, suppose A is 2, 2 belongs to n, so minus 2 will not belong to n. So this way, minus A does not belong to N. If minus A is not in N, minus A cannot be inverse of A for the addition operation on N. Although minus A satisfies A plus minus A equal to 0, minus A plus A equal to 0, but minus A does not belong to the given set N. Therefore, we cannot take minus A in this set. So it will not be inverse of A. Similarly, if your A not equal to 1, in N, 1 upon A will not be belongs to N. Again, you take A as any belongs to N, suppose 5 belongs to N. If phi belongs to n, 1 upon phi will not belong to n. This way, a belongs to n, that means 1 upon a will not belong to n, which implies that other than 1 only, no element of n has been inverse for multiplication operation of n. Only 1 is the inverse of 1. Other than 1, for any element you take, 2 as 1 upon 2 will not, does not belong to n. 3, 1 upon 3 will not be belongs to n. Only 1 will have, but in question a not equal to 1 given, we don't have to take 1, and all other elements in n, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever you take in n, its inverse will be 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4, and they are not belongs to n, so it will not have inverse for multiplication of. So this way we have seen this definition 14 also, and related to that examples 39 and 40 also. So you are suggested to complete the homework as on exercise 1.4, because after this you have this exercise 1.4 and you will be able to solve this exercise. As we have seen definitions and examples very well, on the basis of that this exercise is there. On binary operation it is totally, and all type of binary operations, they are commutative, when they are associative, when they have identity element, and when they have invertible or not, all type of questions you will find here and you can solve it. Seeing this video again and again, you will be able to be confident in solving that exercise.